later, Thomas puffed proudly into Natford Station with Annie and Clarabel. He was very excited. Sir Topham Hatt, Lady Hatt, and Dowager Hatt.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
The station master, Thomas smiled. But the flight controller's mother wasn't smiling. She wasn't smiling. She made Thomas feel nervous.
Just then,
Percy chuffed into the station.
You'll have a wonderful time.
Percy.
Nope.
Thomas whooshed and weeshed through the countryside. Annie and Clarabel clattered and chattered. Finally, they arrived at the beautiful Shen Valley. There were woods and streams. Thomas was sure the Fat Controller's mother would like this. It was the perfect place for a picnic.
Nope.
The Fat Controller, his wife, and his mother, but they didn't smile. The fields had just been ploughed into thick brown mud. Cinders and ashes.
We can't picnic here, but hurry up.
3,000 years later.
This is my best idea yet, Chuff Thomas. At the castle station, the Fat Controller spoke to the station master.
Thomas, said the Fat Controller, the castle is closed. The castle, please have another idea and be quick about it.
Meanwhile, at the Krusty
Krab. The Fat Controller, his wife and his mother were bounced and bumped inside the carriage. Thomas went faster and faster, trying to have another idea.
Mon died.
The Fat Controller leaned out of the window.
Enough, Thomas, he boomed. Stop!
No!
Where are you taking us now?
Nowhere.
Then we will have to cancel the birthday picnic. After my mother wants to go home.
Thomas hoped he'd have another idea before he got to Napford.
The next day.
The Fat Controller, his wife and his mother got off the train. And with a low toot, Thomas chuffed sadly back to Tidmouth.